morning students. In the previous class we have learned about sentence and its features, and also I told you about that sentence has two parts, subject and predicate. Now today we are going to learn object. Before that I would like to tell you what is a verb in a sentence. A verb is an action word, which is done by the subject. Like she cries loudly. What is the action here? Cries. Okay, so before understanding object, you need to also understand difference between transitive and intransitive verb. Verbs are of two types, transitive and intransitive. Transitive verb is a verb which requires an object to complete its sense. That is a transitive verb. Without an object, a verb cannot make its own sense. On the other hand, intransitive verb is a verb which does not require an object to complete its sense. Okay, understood the difference between transitive and intransitive verb? Okay, now come to today's topic, that is object. So let us see here what is an object. An object is a part of the predicate in a sentence. It receives the action done by the subject. It means here it is clearly understood that whatever action is done in the sentence, that is done by the subject, and the action passes over to the object. So here mainly object's work is to receive the action by the subject. Now we are also going to study here, there we can divide object into two parts, that is direct object and indirect object. Before that, let us go through some examples of object so that you can understand clearly. For example, first example I have written here, I throw a ball. If a ball will not be there, only I throw will be there, does it making complete sense? No, it requires an object to complete its sense. Here I is subject and throw is verb, but which verb is it? It is a transitive verb because it requires an object to complete its sense. So here we have added I threw a ball. Now it's making a complete sense. Now second example is, in the same way, I sing a song. Third, I wrapped a gift. So here we can see the verb sing and wrapped both required an object to complete the sense. अभी हमने क्या पढ़ा? हमने पढ़ा ऑब्जेक्ट के बारे में. सबसे पहले मैंने आपको बताया था कि ट्रांजिटिव वर्ब और इंट्रांजिटिव वर्ब क्या होता है. ट्रांजिटिव वर्ब वो वर्ब होता है जिसको ऑब्जेक्ट की जरूरत होती है अपना मीनिंग कंप्लीट करने के लिए. बिना ऑब्जेक्ट के उसका मीनिंग, उसका सेंस कंप्लीट नहीं होगा. इंट्रांजिटिव वर्ब वो वर्ब होता है जिसको ऑब्जेक्ट की जरूरत नहीं होती है, वो अपना मीनिंग अपने में ही कंप्लीट कर लेता है. उसके बाद मैंने आपको बताया कि ऑब्जेक्ट क्या होता है. ऑब्जेक्ट सेंटेंस में प्रेडिकेट का पार्ट होता है और वो सब्जेक्ट द्वारा किए गए एक्शन को लेता है. यानी कि जो सब्जेक्ट हुआ वो डूअर हुआ, वो एक्शन कर रहा है, और उससे पास हुआ ऑब्जेक्ट पर एक्शन. तो ऑब्जेक्ट जो है वो सब्जेक्ट के द्वारा किए गए काम को अपने ऊपर लेता है. उसके बाद मैंने आपको एग्जाम्पल्स के थ्रू बताया, जैसे आई थ्रो अ बॉल, यहाँ पर थ्रो वर्ब है, आई सब्जेक्ट है. लेकिन आई थ्रो सिर्फ कंप्लीट सेंस नहीं हो रहा है, तो उसके साथ यहाँ पर हमने ऑब्जेक्ट को जोड़ा. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आई थ्रो अ बॉल, आई सिंग अ सॉन्ग, मैंने गाना गाया, आई रैप्ड अ गिफ्ट, मैंने गिफ्ट पैक किया या रैप किया. So students, now we are going to discuss types of objects. We have divided objects into two types, direct object and indirect object. First come to direct object. A object that receives the action of a verb directly is called a direct object. Jo verb, it answers the question who, what, whom. So direct object kya hota hai? Noun hota hai ya noun phrase या प्रनाउन होता है जो कि वर्ब के एक्शन को डायरेक्टली रिसीव करता है, और ये इन सब क्वेश्चंस के आंसर्स देता है. व्हाट, हु और हुम, जो भी इन क्वेश्चंस के आंसर्स देगा वो होगा डायरेक्ट object. Now come to indirect object. Indirect object is a noun, noun phrase or pronoun which does not receive the action of a verb directly. It receives the action of a verb indirectly. Indirect वो ऑब्जेक्ट होता है जो कि वर्ब का एक्शन डायरेक्टली रिसीव नहीं करता है, जो कि इनडायरेक्ट वे में करता है. जैसे कि फॉर एग्जांपल आई हैव रिटन एग्जांपल हियर. नाउ इट विल बी मोर क्लियरली अंडरस्टूड विद एन एग्जांपल. लेट अस सी द एग्जांपल. द टीचर गेव स्वीट्स टू द चिल्ड्रेन. नाउ हियर गेव इज वर्ब. व्हाट डिड शी गिव? स्वीट्स. सो स्वीट्स इज direct object. To whom she has given? The children. So the children is an indirect object. Indirect object answers the question at whom, for whom, from whom, to whom. In sub question ke answers jab aapko milenge to wo ho jayega indirect object. And you have to also remember that indirect object often comes after preposition. Yani ki preposition ke baad aata hai. And there cannot be an indirect object without a direct object in the sentence. Sentence mein bina direct object ke indirect object nahi hoga. Now this also we are going to study with an example. Now let us understand indirect object with an example. For example, first is he passed a packet to Nikki. उसने packet किसको pass किया? Nikki को. So it answers the question to whom. तो ये क्या हुआ Nikki? Indirect object. Understood? अब आप लोगों को ये भी ध्यान रखना है कि indirect object can come before direct object and after direct object also. Let us understand with this example. Rama gave the notes to me. Rama ne notes mujhe diye. Ya ye bhi ho sakta hai. Rama gave me the notes. So here me is indirect object and here me is indirect object. But in these two sentences, indirect object is coming after direct object. What is direct object? The notes. And here the notes is coming after indirect object. So this was the difference between direct object and indirect object. आप लोगों को बस यही याद रखना है कि direct object वो होता है जो verb के द्वारा action directly receive करता है, और indirect object वो होता है जो verb के द्वारा action indirect way में receive करता है. So this was the topic for today. I hope you all have understood well.